In this video lecture, we will understand purchasing power parity. Purchasing power parity, or PPP in short, is a popular metric to compare the economic productivity and exchange rates between countries. But before understanding purchasing power parity, the question that might come to your mind is, what is purchasing power? Purchasing power, also known as buying capacity, is the amount of goods and services that one unit of money can buy. For example, if $1 in the US bought 2 gallons of gas in 2005, and now $1 buys only 1 gallon, then this is the change in the purchasing power of the USD. Now let's understand purchasing power parity. It states that the exchange rate between two countries is equal to the ratio of the currency's respective purchasing power. The simplest way to calculate the purchasing power parity between two countries is to compare the price of a basket of goods which is identical across countries. We will understand this with the help of the Big Mac Index, or BMI. The Big Mac Index uses the price of a Big Mac hamburger as the benchmark, replacing the basket of goods. If the price of a Big Mac is $1 in the USA and 60 Indian rupees in India, the exchange rate should be a matter of finding the ratio of these two prices. Thus, if we divide the price of hamburger in India to the price of hamburger in the USA, we get the exchange rate of the Indian rupee to US dollar. This means that USD is equal to 60 Indian rupees. Does the absolute PPP hold? Actually, it doesn't. Here are some of the reasons why absolute PPP doesn't hold. Non-tradable goods. There are non-tradable goods which cannot be exported and imported, such as the public services. It is difficult to account for such expenses and incorporate them in any basket of goods. This partially explains why the absolute PPP and the exchange rate between two currencies are not equal. Taxes and trade restrictions. Taxes in one country are different from another. If taxes are high in one country relative to other, meaning that the goods will sell at a relatively high price in the high tax country. Governments also impose a tariff on imported goods, which ultimately increases the price of goods. Relative purchasing power parity. Since purchasing power parity doesn't look into reality, we move to relative purchasing power parity. Relative PPP takes inflation into account. It does so by considering the relationship between changes of the exchange rate and changes of the price ratio. Note that price level will increase if there is an increase in inflation. Let's take an example. Suppose the exchange rate between India and the USA is 60 Indian rupees per USD. The expected annual inflation rate for the USA is 2%, and the expected annual inflation rate in India is 5%. This means that relative to the prices in the US, prices in India are rising approximately at a rate of 3%. We reach to this number by using the formula 1 plus A minus 1 plus B, where A is the expected annualized inflation rate of India. B is the expected annualized inflation rate of the USA. So the new exchange rate would be 61 Indian rupees and 80 paise per dollar. PPP exchange rates are considered less volatile than market exchange rates. Market exchange rates tend to be influenced by other factors such as government intervention, trading, and hedging. On the other hand, PPP rates are often difficult to determine due to differences in the economics of countries, but once it is calculated, it is less volatile than the market rate. That is all for this video.